Another instrument of trade policy is to help local producers by giving them subsidies. The main difference with the analysis of a tariff is that, first of all, a subsidy can be given to producers that are that are suffering from import, but it can also be given in a situation in which the country is actually exporting goods. And this is the type of situation that we are analyzing in this example. We have PW that is greater than PA, so there's incentives for the producers to export the consumption good. The government decides to help the producers by giving them an extra transfer, which is our subsidy. This will simply produce a shift to the right of the supply curve, or in this case, supply line, actually. So basically, with a subsidy to production, each producer receives a fixed payment from the government. The result is that now less efficient producers will be able and willing to produce after the subsidy is in place. We'll notice now that though this doesn't really affect consumers because they are facing the same world price as before the subsidy is given by the government. So while a tariff was distorting the international price by creating a wedge, here the subsidy is not really having an impact on the price of the good, it's rather directly helping producers, and so in a sense there's a less distortions than when we are going to manipulate prices. So the situation doesn't change for consumers whose surplus is the same. The producer surplus will increase because now if I were producing, now I'm receiving some money. If I wasn't producing, I'm receiving some money and I might be able to produce. So this is going to increase exports and increase producer surplus by an amount which in our picture is given by the areas D and E. However, this policy measure has a cost. For each unit that is produced, the government has to pay an amount of subsidy. So what is the government surplus from giving a subsidy? It's going to be a negative surplus because it's an expenditure, and so we don't know how the government is going to exactly finance this, but it has to take money from someone in the economy. And the amount of expenditure for this subsidy is given by the area D, E, F. If we do the simple math, we can see that there's a final total net change, which is a loss. And this total loss is equal to the area F. So this small triangle F is the deadweight loss from imposing a subsidy. And it tells us that even in this case, the economy would have been better off by just committing to free trade.